Good afternoon, everyone. I have a special Friday Crafternoon edition for you this week. Anyone out there who is a Harry Potter fan like myself, you know today is Harry's birthday. So, we will be making a mandrake. But don't worry, this one will be quiet. And some flying keys. And we'll also be making Harry's birthday cake. Just for decorative purposes, not to eat. But if you are all ready to have a magical afternoon with me, then follow me and we're gonna head over to the library. So we are going to make some flying keys. I happen to have these left over from wedding favors, I believe, but you can find these in packs on Amazon for not too much money. I'm sure eBay as well. You might be able to find some at the craft store. I just had these lying around, so that's the ones I'm gonna use. For your wings, any kind of plastic that's not too thick that you have lying around. This is from a box of ornaments left over from Christmas. I saved it for this. And then you're gonna need a wing template. Or if you wanna just draw your own, that's fine too. I got this template from a YouTuber that I watch, Cherry Wallace. She does all Harry Potter things. And she linked this in one of her videos, so this is what I'm gonna be using. And all you're gonna do is trace your wings on the plastic with a Sharpie. It certainly doesn't have to be perfect, which is the beauty of this, because those keys were antique, old looking. If you remember, there's even one that's really not in great shape, its wings or its key. So it's completely okay if you don't get this perfect. And then design is completely up to you. You can freehand it if you want. I'm not great at that, so that's why I'm gonna use a template. There are our traced wings. So now you're just gonna cut them out. I do say use plastic that is at least semi-flexible for these, because you do want them to be able to move a little bit when they're hanging. There are our wings. So all you want to do is really just tape them to your key. I'm going to tape mine underneath a little bit. So hopefully I'm going to give it the effect that they are in motion. You want to use, if you have glue, hot glue, you can definitely bend your wings a little bit and glue them to the top if you want. I am going to use a little bit of clear tape. You definitely want very clear tape if you're going to do it the way I'm doing it. And you're just gonna place the wings underneath and make sure they're bent up a little bit. Just tape it to the top of your key like so. And now you've got your flying keys. You can then put a string on it if you want to hang them from the ceiling, if you have clear fishing wire. I'm going to put mine on my Christmas tree at Christmas, so I'm just going to add a hook to mine. But that's all there is to it. Just trace your wings on plastic, tape them or glue them on, and you're ready to go. I hope you've enjoyed this magical craft, and now we are on to our next one. So if you would like a really easy, low maintenance plant to take care of, look no further, because we are going to make a mandrake today. This is all the materials you're going to need. I'm using Spanish moss. You can use any kind of moss, real dirt if you'd like, some leaves. I'm not going to be using these pumpkins, but I liked the leaves for this. A little pot, Sharpie, and some styrofoam. I definitely recommend buying a piece that would fit this better, but this is what I had, so I'm trying to use what's on hand, and a glue gun. So while the glue gun is heating up, I'm gonna cut my styrofoam down just to have a little piece to stick our greenery into. Any kind of foam really that you have will work. And actually that fits so nice and snugly, I don't even feel like I need the glue gun. But if you want to, the other step would be to put glue in the bottom of your pot so your foam sticks really nicely. And then we're going to use some leaves on here. I got these at Dollar Tree, but you can get them really at any craft store. And usually they just bend off easily enough. If not, you can use snips, you can use scissors to get them off. Pumpkins just come off very easily. You can always save those for a craft later on if you want. Okay. And so all you're really gonna do is just stick your leaves in, however many you want, and then actually just lay that one in there. Just make sure you take, if you have the pumpkins, make sure you take all of them off. The other way you can make a mandrake is if you are very talented with clay, which I'm not, you can actually make your little mandrake inside, and that would look pretty much exactly like it does in the movie. I think that's actually enough for our mandrake. And now you're gonna open up your moss. This is where it gets messy. You have been warned. And you're just going to stick it around your base to cover up your styrofoam. You can use as much or as little as you want. And there we've got our potted plant. And now what you're gonna do is take your Sharpie and just make a little face on it. Mandrakes tend to be angry and yelling, so there you have it. If you want, you can always paint your pot too, if you want it to be a different color, if you want it to be a darker brown, but I thought this was a pretty good color. So, enjoy your mandrake plant. I hope it doesn't give you too many sleepless nights. And I have one more magical craft to show you guys. Alright, for our last craft, not sure if you can guess what this is going to be. If you remember, Hagrid brings Harry a birthday cake, a very cracked, sat-on birthday cake, but still a birthday cake, and that's what we're going to try to make today. So you'll need a piece of styrofoam, some spackle. I did find this at Dollar Tree, so don't feel like you need to go out and buy a whole tub of spackle for this. Hopefully, if you're a homeowner, you have some around the house, maybe left over from something. And I have pink ink here that I'm going to dye the spackle with. That's another reason I recommend a small tub that you can mix right into there. And this green puff paint. To write on the cake with. So I'm gonna cut open my foam. You can make this any size you want. This one happens to be almost 4 inches wide. And again, this is just a prop. This is not for eating purposes. And here is our tub of spackle. I already have it opened. It was a little difficult to crack open. And I'm using, I buy these alcohol inks by Ranger, but any kind of ink, or if you wanna try mixing some paint, this is gumball that I'm gonna try. And I'm gonna use this for a few other crafts too, which is another reason I'm choosing to make this whole thing pink. It's definitely going to get messy, so don't be afraid of that. If you want to wear gloves, that's good too. It's definitely getting there to the right color. You do want to make sure it's nice and mixed, that there's not really any white streaks or any dark pink streaks either. You of course can choose any colors you want. I want to make it authentic to look like it does in the movie. So you will want pink frosting for your cake and green puff paint for the lettering if you want it to look exactly like it. just to make sure, you know, if you do this at home, that your husband or boyfriend is okay with you ruining some spackle and making it pink. That looks pretty good, actually. And you're just gonna wanna cover your styrofoam. And don't forget, it definitely shouldn't look like a perfectly smooth cake because it wasn't in a movie, it was a hot mess. It's okay if you make a mess of your table, we can clean all that up later. This is going to be a messy craft. Like I said, don't make it perfect. It shouldn't be perfect. Make sure you cover all your surfaces, but it does not need to be perfect. Definitely make sure you cover all the surfaces. You don't want to see any green or white or whatever other color spackle, and styrofoam that you might have. Definitely makes me glad I don't actually have to spackle anything in the house. It would be a tough job. Don't be afraid to use your hands a little bit. All right, there is our cake. What you want to do is take your puff paint and you're going to write "Happy Birthday, Harry." So remember, Hagrid doesn't know how to spell. So, and there you go. If you want to put one more finishing touch on it, you can get a toothpick or any thin object and just draw your little crack in here. It's a little bit difficult to do with this, but. And then your cake is all done. So now you're all ready for Harry's birthday. You've got your flying keys, your mandrake, and Harry's birthday cake. I do recommend letting this dry for a while, and then enjoy it as your prop. If you make any of these crafts, I would definitely love to see them. Send us a picture. If you do other Harry Potter related things for his birthday, give us a shout. I hope you've enjoyed this magical video, and I will see you in our next one. So I did just want to share one more quick craft idea with you. I did not videotape this one because our amazingly talented Y librarian Fiona is doing a video for this, but I did include this wand in the video and in the picture, so I just wanted to tell you about it. All you need is a chopstick and some hot glue, which you just put around the wand in any design you want, and when it's dry, you'll just paint the wand. And if you want, you can paint over the hot glue part only after that to give it a little more color to the design. But if you pop over and check out Fiona's video, she did a whole video on how to make these. So hope you guys have a magical day and enjoy Harry's birthday.